Okay, evening y'all, this is Renegade Biker 24, and I am off work, and I've got a vlog to talk about tonight, because it's in reference to Noxious Moto's video, which I will post right here. And it's talking about the VA and how he's been treated really poorly at the VA where he's at. Well, first of all, I can tell you that I've had my experience with VA, and this started way before I got the job here. What had happened is, and I think I probably covered this in a different vlog, but I'm going to cover it tonight just to kind of reemphasize the point. But I went to the VA, I'd say it was about 8, maybe 9 years ago. It's been a while. And the VA, what happened is I was going to, I guess it was this NTI, or Northwest Technical Institute, at the time, and I went by the nurses' station there, and what ended up happening is the nurses there that was in the nurses' station at NTI saw me rub my leg, my right leg, and they thought, they said to themselves, and they told me, and they shouted out, "Don't do that." So I asked them, I said, "Why not? It's just an itch." And they said, one of the nurses said, when I asked her, she said that it could be a blood clot. And if you keep rubbing it like that, you could pop it and go straight to your heart and kill you. So I was thinking, oh crap, okay, I'm not going to do that anymore. So what ended up happening is I almost immediately that day or the day after went to the VA here in Fayetteville, the one I work at now. And I had said to the people in there, and I went, I guess, into the emergency room, and I said that I might have a blood clot in my right leg. And they told me, "Nah, you look fine. You look fine." I said, "If you could please run some tests," and I was thinking to myself, just amuse me, you know, just in case. Well, they came back and they said that, or the nurses there said that basically I had a blood clot in my right leg. I'm going, "Oh, really?" But I was thinking to myself, well, duh, didn't I just say that? I think I know my body more than you do. And that's what I was thinking to myself. And so, anyway, they ran some more tests, and they found out that my low cholesterol, or my dangerous cholesterol, which is the LDL, he said it was like about 900. And they said, "That's way too high." And I was thinking, oh crap. So, okay, what could cause that? Well, I was eating beans and, oh, like the El Monterey beans burrito and stuff like that. And I'm thinking that's when I was really into at that time. And they said, "Yeah, you keep going like that, your cholesterol is gonna kill you." And I go, "Oh crap." Well, anyway, So they admitted me into the hospital, and I was there for a week. During this week, they had me hooked up to heparin, which is a blood thinner. And then I was hooked into an IV set, and that's what I was doing for about a week. So I was on heparin, and then they switched me to Coumadin. And they also had me on painkillers because the pain was still there because of my right leg. And they had said, and they had, I think they had done some tests on me, and they said that one of the valves that regulates the blood flow to my leg, my right leg, was destroyed. And I'm wondering, is there anything that I can do to rebuild that? I just don't understand it. So, but anyway, they have yet to do, I guess, another sonogram on my right leg, because my right leg is actually more swollen than my left leg. But anyway, they ran some tests with me still being in there, and it got down to Little Rock, and they told me, well, I got to go down to Little Rock. So I went down to Little Rock to the VA down there, and they told me that I have anti-phospholipid antibody syndrome. Now try to say that three times fast. So anyway, I was told I have this life-threatening disease, which is, like I said, anti-phospholipid antibody syndrome. And that is a disease. It's kind of like, I'm not even sure it would be considered like lupus or anything like that, but it is a life-threatening disease. So basically what that means is that my body produces too much phosphorus and fat, so I'm prone to clots. Well, as I am at the VA, I told them that I think I might need a cane because I was in bed a lot. For that whole week, I was pretty much bedridden, and I had to sponge bathe, which is tough in as it is. And so anyway, I was told to basically, I'm okay. And I said, I think I might need a cane. And one nurse goes, nah, you don't need a cane. I go, yes, I need a cane. And I said, watch me get up and watch me try to walk. So she goes, okay. So I got up and I pretty much couldn't walk. Even though I was fed pretty good, there, it still was to the point of, well, I couldn't walk because I didn't have a whole lot of strength to the leg. And she goes, oh, I guess, Mr. Mike, you need a cane. And I was thinking to myself, well, duh, didn't I just say that? So anyway, what ended up happening is as I'm released, I had a cane, and I was on that cane for, gosh, it seems like a couple months. And that cane, it pretty much helped me get my strength back in my leg. so now I don't really need a cane. But I know eventually I probably will need a cane again. But anyway, so that's what ended up happening. Now that's my experience with the VA. Now I had before that to fight tooth and nail with going to my state representative because I believe that I was that I had to get my disability or my service connected disability, and the VA at the time didn't want to give me it. So I, along with help from some member of my family, told me to contact my state representative, and that's what I did. And basically, that's what ended up happening. And they pretty much re-examined the case, and well, I have my service-connected disability for when I was in, and I split my nose wide open on the carrier when I did the FOD walkdown on the carrier before flight ops, which was the USS Nimitz. So anyway, that's what ended up happening, and that's my experience with the VA. Now, what I've also experienced with the VA is that you pretty much have to talk with their patient advocate. You have to talk with their patient advocate because that's what you need to do. And if you don't talk with him, or if he can't get in touch with him, that's your first line of help, and then you go to your state representative, whoever that is, and depending on your state and your district, you've got to talk to them, or him or her, and you've got to get them the information of your case, and that's if the patient advocate doesn't help you, which that's what happened with me. So I am going to excuse me. I'm going to let y'all know about that because that's been my experience. So the VA has had a lot of situations with what happened recently in Phoenix, which to me, that is the guy responsible is John McCain. So it's under his state. Yeah, he keeps getting reelected, which he's been in there for 8 terms, which is longer than the Constitution allows. So it's up to you all to really, really tell the VA and your state representative that, you know what, you're not going to put up with this stuff. And it is up to each veteran to do that. We really have to band together and really have to start pressuring the politicians to actually follow through with their so-called commitment to the veterans. So if you all have a problem with the VA, that is what I suggest. And if you all can, especially Noxious Moto, remember, talk to your state representative if your patient advocate doesn't help you out. That's what I did, and that's what I suggest you all do. And that's what I have for you today. This is Renegade Biker 24, and I will layer.